trying to be great, and I'm on my way. Way up, way up, way up. It's never too late, and I'm on my way.
I'ma leave my mark. Ready, set, go. Ready, set, go. Ready, set.
With so much negativity being yielded at the youth of our nation, it seems hard to find any signs of a bright future. Coming from a legendary past, the new generation of Bahamians seek to take this nation to heights it's never seen. That's where the youth perspective comes in. We seek to display tomorrow's leaders in every facet of society. Each show will focus on today's pace setters, trendsetters, movers and shakers, and the next generation of great, impactful Bahamians. We seek to uplift, motivate, and encourage our listeners. Tune in as we address issues of importance with wisdom and intelligence, all from the youth perspective.
And we're back. Welcome to another edition of The Youth Perspective with yours truly, Kashigan Jamal. We thank you so much for being a part of the show, and thank you so much for locking it in on 1540 AM, 104.5 FM, the national voice of the Bahamas, and Inspiration 107.9 FM, where it's all gospel all the time. And listen, ladies and gentlemen, we have a guest joining us, but no stranger to The Youth Perspective. He's been with us quite a number of times. He's back again, ladies and gentlemen, but this time, in person, not on Zoom, ladies and gentlemen. And so we have Coach Ricardo Miller in studio. Good evening. How are you doing, sir?
Man, Kashigan, thank you so much for the opportunity again. I've always enjoyed my sessions. As a matter of fact, a few months ago, I was watching one of our sessions. I think you had it on YouTube as well. Mm-hmm. And I was listening to it, and I said, man, I had to do this again. And so I reached out to you, and man, mm-hmm. Grateful for the opportunity.
Yes, sir. It's always great when we get to have you in studio, when we get to have conversations, because you always leave us with nuggets.
Thank you.
Be able to help to progress our lives, help to grow in our lives. And so at this midway point of the year, what are you feeling in your spirit? What are you thinking through?
You know, there are a lot of people, Kashika, when the year begun, they said this was their year.
Yeah.
This is the year. Unfortunately, mid-year, they're looking at themselves and they're saying nothing has changed. They're saying nothing has changed. And almost, just out of habits, are more inclined to move towards, I'm just going to let this year clock out with the anticipation of waiting another year. And I think it's a mistake. So what I would say to someone at this mid-junction of this year, there's still time. There's still time to get a lot of things done, but a person has to be very intentional. I'm of the belief, you know, the Bible says, Kashika, that where there's no vision, the people perish. The inability to see the future hinders you from having a great one. Let me say it again. The inability to see a great future hinders you from having a great one. You're going to get what you see. Somebody said, well, you know, years ago, I thought about the statement. I heard Dr. Miles Monroe said it at a New Year's night service. He said something like, so where are you going? And somebody would say, I'm going to the mall. That's as far as they could see.
Right.
You know, they said, man, I ain't got nothing going on this weekend. Hey, what you plan to do this month? Well, you know, boy, I ain't know what I doing this month. What you doing this year? Boy, I ain't sure. Wasted time leads to a wasted life. You see, wasted time. So the truth is, a person just has to be very committed to capturing their heart's cry. This year, 6 months, what can I still do? And believe it or not, it don't have to be nothing grandiose, you know. A lot of times we want to do big, but it's really about being faithful at small.
Yes. And being consistent.
Oh, man, being consistent. Yeah. Being consistent with small. And then here's the deal. Celebrating your wins along the way will get you so much further than seeing this grand element of what you want in the finish, because that's what vision is. Vision is the ability to see the end of the beginning, but most people don't consistently stick with it.
Now, you know, we are in a social media generation, right? And so we're talking about TikTok Reels is only like 10 seconds, right? And so how does one stay focused, stay laser focused in this very short content created life that we're living right now?
Going back to vision again, vision determines your commitment to reading the book. Vision determines turning off the TV. Vision determines how you're going to spend your money. Vision determines how long you're going to give TikTok, Facebook, Instagram. Vision determines who's going to be your friends. Vision determines what time you get up, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Vision determines if you could afford to watch that Law and Order marathon all day on Saturday.
Yes.
You
yes.
catch what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yes, I, man, listen, I signed up for TikTok, right? Mm-hmm. And I was watching. An hour goes by yes. watching these 30-second things. Mm. Like, I mean, you could lose time like that.
Yeah.
But because I know who I want to be, mm-hmm. and I don't have the time to waste in my pursuit to being who I want to be, I've checked out and used, like, okay, only on the weekends, I will check on TikTok. Mm-hmm. Do you know on social media, I post almost every hour, okay? If a person is a friend of mine, it's the only way they don't see my stuff is if they hide me.
Right.
Okay? And some people do. Yeah. But because I'm a little much, right?
Right.
But here's the deal. I don't ever go on the news feed, you know. I don't ever go on the news feed.
Yeah.
If I go on the news feed, it's because I'm going to look for somebody, and then I see a couple other things, and I like, comment right then, and then I'm off again because it's addictive. Social media has been built to draw you in.
Yes.
So if you don't capture the importance of your life's vision and goals and put social media and any other distracting thing in its place, which means Apostle Paul said this. He said, all things are permissible to me, but not all things are beneficial.
Right.
I will not be mastered by anything.
Right.
That means I have to have control over this. Somebody said, well, I find it difficult. Guess what? Whatever you find difficult, you can still master if you're patient enough and willing to go the extra mile to learn how to master it. You don't have to throw the baby out with the bathwater. You don't have to, well, I got off of social media completely. Well, now you're throwing the baby out with the bathwater.
Right.
Because we live in a social media-driven society.
Yes.
Social media is the way. You know, it's not going anywhere. But then learning how to bring it under control is the key.
Yes. So learning how to schedule those posts is very key.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I do.
Yeah.
I'm scheduling posts. Yeah. One lady said to me a couple of months back, she says, Coach, I think you got sleeping issues. I said, pardon me? She says, I mean, I'm studying and I'm doing school bookmarks, and she said, I'm up all the time doing work for school. She's in education. She said, I'll pop on my Facebook page, and at 2 a.m., something pop up from Coach Ricardo Miller. She said, and this has happened more than a dozen times.
Yes.
She said, do you have sleeping issues? I said, it's called scheduling posts.
Yes.
She said, pardon me?
It's key.
I said, I schedule. And I said, I schedule the thought that I think someone needs to hear at 2 a.m.
I want to, funny enough, I was just looking at some of my older posts because, you know, I repost some of the older posts. And there was a quote that I posted a few years ago by Jim Collins. And he said that good is the enemy of great. And so going back to what you were talking about, you know, persons looking at their life and where they are now, realizing that it may be good, but there is better. And realizing that we can achieve and we can go better. How do we go to better?
Making a commitment to getting better with age. It's like every day. I tell my son, I tell my wife, I say my mantra is Ricardo Miller, getting better with age. Now, what does that mean? How can I get better? Now, here's the deal. Somebody said, well, you know, cash, we're going to need you. Oh, I don't do that. I'm not good with that. Then you're not getting better. Oh, your daughter's needing you to do something. Oh, you know, that's not me. You're not getting better. Your wife is needing you to do something. I'm not getting better. The job is demanding. But if you're going to commit to getting better, you start realizing the one thing that is consistent with humanity is change.
Change, yeah.
And if change is inevitable, and I'm saying I'm getting better, and Kashika, I'm right now 47, be 48 in October, I would love to live another 48 years. But what if I stop changing now? What if I stop growing? What if I stop embracing the concept of getting better? What will happen is life will become more frustrating to me and everything will pass me by. And that's the problem. The problem is we don't get better until we commit to a life of improvement. There is no arrival. There is no arrival.
It's a journey.
It's a journey. A journey. And when you embrace effective living, what I talk about in my book, my latest book, it's all about the journey. It's all about the journey. Once you embrace that, it changes everything.
And I think one thing that persons would notice by looking at your posts is you really do exude effective living. Thank you. You know, by your Thank posts, you. By your lifestyle, from what I see
yep.
personally,
yep.
I said, this dude is really effective living. Like, he is just talking to stuff.
My wife yeah. will tell you, I made a commitment.
Yeah.
I said, listen, mm-hmm. I hired an assistant. And yeah. her and I were talking one time, and she's a beast. She's incredible. She helped made my company phenomenal in so many ways.
Yeah.
And she says, Coach, we mm-hmm. got to make more money.
Mm.
And she said, we could make more money if we do this. I said, those are not my priority. Mm. Then she says, can you help me to understand your priority? I say, number one priority for me and Effective Living LLC, the business at this point,
mm-hmm.
is that I live the message.
Mm.
Number one.
Yeah.
I says, that's number one. She says, what's number two? I said, number two is that I find a community who's wanting to live it with me.
Right.
She said, what's number three? Number three is mm-hmm. getting someone to pay me for living the way I live.
Mm-hmm.
Come on,
that's
guys.
Beautiful.
Come
that's
on,
beautiful.
Man. That's where I'm creating a life I don't need a vacation from.
Yeah.
Because the life I live is my message.
Mm-hmm.
But my message is what I get paid for.
Yeah.
Woo, come on, three in one.
Yeah.
Three in one. And that takes work. So mm-hmm. here's the deal. I don't have it all together, though.
Right.
So I'm working on the marriage. I'm working on the health. I'm working on the parenting. I'm working on the finance. I'm working on the faith. I'm working on the social connection. I'm working on just knowing that when I lay down, I'm good with me.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't please everybody. I ain't going to be everybody's cup of tea. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, the question is, do I feel as though God is pleased with how I'm showing up?
Yeah. Yeah, that's incredible. Because at the end of the day,
yeah.
you want to hear well done.
I want to hear well done. I want to hear well done. And here's the deal. What I found, Kashika, I'm at the age now. I'm seeing some people I've truly admired for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
They find themselves at an aging point where regret is revealing itself.
Yes.
And I think regret is the most sorriest place to live. I think regret. Wishing they had spent time with their kids. Wishing that when they did travel, they didn't just shop. Wishing that they had enjoyed the marriage, not just staying married. They wishing that they made faith alive, not just be religious, but literally walk with God.
Mm.
Like regret is a sorry place. And so I said to myself, at this age, I don't want to live a life of regret.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't want to deny myself of the chance to live life fully. And I had to start doing the work. And that's what my book is about.
Yeah. And I think, you know, as we talk about it, and we're going to talk about the book just a second. As my bishop was telling me about something, he was saying that this generation is so destination focused that they only think about the end in mind. And, you know, we talked about enjoying the journey. But sometimes the journey is horrible. Sometimes it's rough. Sometimes it's, you know, it keeps you up at night.
but it all depends on how you prepare for the journey.
That's true.
It's all dependent on when I ran the marathon. I only ran one marathon. I said when I ran my last marathon, I wanted to say it like that. What I ran, but you know, I did four half marathons and ran a marathon.
Okay.
And when I was running, they told you preparing for it, you got to make sure you got the right shoes. You got to make sure you have the right clothes. You got to know where the hills are. You got to know where the valleys are. You got to know where the water stops are. You got to know where the restroom breaks are.
Yeah.
If you go on a road trip, if you've done road trips in the U.S., you're going from Fort Lauderdale to New York.
Yeah.
You got to map that thing out and figure out where you're going to stop for gas, put what you're going to put in the car on your journey. If you kids in the car, you want to put some movies in there, the music, your playlist of music. It's preparing for the journey. Most people are on a journey they haven't prepared for. Most people are on a journey. And so you get married with the intent to do a journey life with this person, but y'all didn't really prepare for the journey. You bring kids.
That's a different show altogether.
You bring kids into this world.
Yeah.
And you didn't prepare for the journey.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You make money,
mm-hmm.
but then you didn't prepare for a career journey.
Because
career journeys have different types of, and it's just just preparing for the journey. And here's the deal. Everything about our lives can be examined. And most people are only impressed with what everyone else is impressed about them. But they're in denial about the things that only them know, but they need to address that nobody else knows.
Yeah.
So if I got a degree, well, you know, I just got my master's, man. But you ain't sleeping at night.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about that. Mm-hmm. Oh, man, just made $1 million. Just made $1 million. but your wife left you.
Mm-hmm.
Or, but your kids ain't talking to you.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Or, man, you're in a backslidden state. You hadn't prayed in months. You, mm-hmm. I mean, you haven't even opened your Bible for a while. You're not in a good place, but you look like you're in a good place.
Yeah.
And so the Bible talks about having a form of godliness,
mm-hmm.
but denying the power thereof.
Wow.
I think the power thereof is being the full manifestation of Christ in the earth.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible said, let your light shine so men will see. And I think when we talk about the journey, mm-hmm. it's no one's perfect.
Yes.
Boy, well, let me tell you something. I was doing a class last week, and I told the group, I said, when I got the revelation mm-hmm. that no one's perfect, Rick Warren lost a son
mm-hmm.
by suicide. The past president has been impeached. Mm-hmm. The current president fell down on a stage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just life.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Life. You know, you're Michael Jackson, you died overdose. You're mm-hmm. Whitney Houston. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just, no one is exempt mm-hmm. from having challenges.
Yes.
Now, the question is, how are you going to manage your life
right.
to ensure that you don't get overtaken by your challenges
yeah.
and you surpass the bumps in the road mm-hmm. to still having an amazing life? And that's what I believe people should be about.
As we get ready to wrap up, we want to get a word of encouragement
yep.
to our young persons mm-hmm. listening in from all over
yep.
and every island, nook, cranny, yep. and key. And of course, your closing comments.
Listen, I want to say someone is succeeding in every environment.
Mm.
That statement right there needs to resonate with those on the family of islands
mm-hmm.
that are as far away that think Nassau is it.
Yeah.
And then those in Nassau who think this is the struggling base, you know. Someone is succeeding
yeah.
in every environment. Now, the question is, can I get a revelation mm-hmm. and a passion and a commitment
mm-hmm.
to be the one?
Mm-hmm.
Here's what I know.
Mm-hmm.
As you're listening today,
mm-hmm.
someone's coming out of this year with everything they could.
Yes.
In other words, I tell myself, someone's going to win today.
Mm-hmm.
Why not me?
Mm-hmm.
Someone's going to win this month. Why not me? Someone's going to win this year. Why not me? There's going to be a game changer in the Bahamas.
Yes. Yes, sir.
You guess what I'm saying? There's
yeah.
going to be a game changer in the island where I'm at.
Mm-hmm.
Someone is going to elevate the game.
Mm-hmm.
Why not me?
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, we live in an environment sometimes where no one is saying that enough around us. So
mm-hmm.
if we're looking for that to come from external, it may mm-hmm. never come.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to have that self-talk.
Yeah.
Once you capture something bigger than who you are, you got to then make a commitment to go where possibly no one has gone.
Mm-hmm.
God said to me a few months ago, can I trust you to do something
mm-hmm.
where there's no reference point for you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Can I trust you to do something that no one has done before?
Mm-hmm.
That there's no reference point in. Let's just, I can't call a cousin. I can't call a friend. I call you. You now have to just know that it's like Elon Musk
mm-hmm.
going where no man has gone before.
Yeah.
It's like Jeff Bezos
mm-hmm.
choosing to invest and push an idea, not mm-hmm. just I'm going to try to reinvent Walmart.
Mm.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
Or Amazon. So, you know, Amazon say I'm going to reinvent Walmart and be another Walmart, like
mm-hmm.
how Walmart was the Kmart
right.
before.
Mm-hmm.
Or Netflix simply says, hey, we're going to beat Blockbusters and open more stores.
Yeah.
Now, they say, let's take this where it's never gone before.
Yeah.
I'm saying to young Bahamians, you got to start thinking,
mm-hmm.
someone is going to take it where it's never gone before.
Mm-hmm.
Why not me?
Why not me, yeah.
Why not me? And all to the glory of God.
Mm-hmm.
Because the truth is, that's the way you let your light shine. When mm-hmm. you could become who you were destined to be in Christ,
mm-hmm.
the Bible says in John chapter 15, verse 8, herein is how my Father is glorified, that
mm-hmm.
you bear much fruit. Somebody mm-hmm. say, give glory to God.
Bear fruit.
Bear fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Become a fruit producer.
Any closing comments?
I believe that if you are committed to the next level, help is available to you.
Mm-hmm.
There's a statement that says, when the student is ready, the teacher will appear.
Mm-hmm.
All of us, one of my greatest thing that I had to accept, Cassia, is the help that I need is
mm-hmm.
available.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I had to get past where I was to get to where I needed to go through the mm-hmm. assistance of those who helped me. So in my book, I talk about I'm the collective contribution of a lot of incredible people who have helped me to become who I am today.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I'm self-made.
No.
I don't think anybody's self-made. I think somebody is helping everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody's going to have to help you to get to where you're trying to go.
Yeah.
Jesus himself showed up and says, hey, you, come follow me and I'll make you. Mm-hmm. Not only did they come and follow him, but they came to help him because after they left, they were commissioned.
Yes.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So be willing to embrace the help. That's mm-hmm. what I would say to our listening audience.
And if persons want to connect yep. with Coach Ricardo Miller, yep. how can they do so?
We're on every social media. No, we're not on everyone because there's some of them I just chose not to do bad.
There's a lot of them. You're on the major platforms.
I'm on the major. Facebook, yeah, yeah. Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, you know, YouTube. Mm-hmm. Those five, Coach Ricardo Miller, you mm-hmm. Google me in there. Google me, it'll pop up.
Yeah, you're going to find you. You can't miss you.
Man, thank you so much for having me.
And you know what's that now, so yeah. Any shout-outs?
Man, most certainly a shout-out to my mother. Yeah. Got to give a shout-out to my mom, Eunice Miller, mm-hmm. in Elizabeth Estate. Big shout-out to my wife, Karen Miller. Mm-hmm. Man, listen, she told me, turn it down for what? I was like, listen, boy, the world going to get disrupted from Ricardo Miller because I got a woman next to me saying don't dim for nobody. And so God is good, man. And yeah. so I want to give a shout out to those two women. They're right. amazing.
And then shout out to your son, right? Your son graduated?
My son graduated college, yeah, yeah. just moving on now to do communication. He's okay. Guess what? You're going to have him on the show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because he's a communication major.
Okay.
And
the best
speak.
Major.
Yeah. Hey, he wants to speak. And yeah. so he said, Dad, coach me in the speaking business.
Yeah.
So I told him, I said, hey, every month I'm going to yeah. set the stage for you to do some things. Yeah. And I said, you got this. And so he's doing well. I have my bonus daughter. She's turning 12.
Wow.
And so he's 21. So we got one off to college mm-hmm. and one going into seventh grade in the Dallas area.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're doing parenting, you know.
You're making it out, man.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Obi, thank you so much. I know you got a busy, busy schedule, and yeah. so we appreciate you dropping in.
Man, thank you for always having me. Thank you for the great work that you're doing.
Thank you.
I'm available anytime you need me.
All right. Appreciate you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're locked into The Youth Perspective, where we shine the light on the youth of our nation. Yours truly, Kashuk and Jamal. We'll see you on the next show. Have a great evening, everyone.
I'm trying to be great, and I'm on my way. It's never too late, and I'm on my way.
I'ma leave my mark. Ready, set, go. Ready, set, go. Ready, set, go.
I hope you enjoyed another edition of The Youth Perspective. Stay tuned for more interviews, more in-depth conversation, great music, as we seek to encourage, empower, impact, and uplift our youth of this nation. Here on The Youth Perspective, we'll see you next time right here on The Youth Perspective with Kashuk and Jamal.